Hi all, Hipper here. Today I am taking out the Charles Martel, and it is arguably the best tech tree cruiser in the game. And I am using my Agile Roop build here, and like I've said a few times before, this build is very expensive in terms of resources, because you have two event commanders that you need to level very, very highly, and of course the standard commander Roo in himself as well. So getting this build up and running will take a long time and will take a lot of resources. But once you've got it, it is amazing. I think so. All right, so as you can see, every time in a Martel game, I pop the speed boost immediately, because it also helps a little bit on acceleration, so you might as well use it to get the drop on anyone who tries to get into, in this case, the A-cap here in front of me. That's one of the things I do in all Agile Cruisers. I head straight for the cap, and then if it's not too well defended, I try to take it. If it's too well defended, I turn around and I use my Agile build to fire on the enemy while I get into a more like pleasant distance, and then I hit the cap again. And I keep doing that until I take the cap, and the enemies die, or the enemies overrun the cap, and I'll have to retreat even further. But yeah, it works the same way, pretty much. Now, I hear a lot of rumors out there about Agile builds, and how some people think that all you do with an Agile build is to sit at the back of the map and fire HE. And, look, I'm sorry, that nothing could be further from the truth. Because, like, an Agile build is what I do in this game here. You use that agility to be within striking distance of battleships and cruisers, of course. But you don't need any cover until you get too close, obviously. So you can see here, I'm evading all their shots, so I can find out where are all the enemies positioned at this time, and how well is this cap defended. And now I can see, okay, there's four ships over here. That is way too much for me to take on. So I'm simply heading back. And of course, I time my turns so I don't get broadsided or something other nasty than that. Of course, but you see, head straight in. And as soon as there's an opening, as soon as this Atlanta here gets behind the rock, I'm going to turn around again and I'm going to try pushing again. And Agile builds are perfect for pushing. And I like to push, and that's why I love Agile builds. So see here, I've only got one guy targeting me now. And the Atlanta can't really hurt me, so I'm going to try to push from a different angle here, where I can get in, and I don't have as many enemies targeting me. Now, another misunderstanding I hear a lot is that in an Agile build you don't shoot from cover. Oh, that's just wrong. Of course you do. Anytime you can get away with shooting from cover, obviously that is like the better approach. Except if you hit straight into the mountain like here, I don't know why I was firing there. But shooting from cover, and especially if you are undetected yourself, is of course preferable to any other way of engaging the enemy. Of course, it depends on the circumstances, of course, with just like everything else in this game. But in general, of course, it's better to fire the enemy when they can't see you. So, like if you can shoot from cover, obviously do that. Agile builds are really really meant to make you able to pump out damage no matter the circumstances. Like if you have a pure AP, HE, or a range build, or a reload build, or something like that, you can still hide behind an island and shoot, of course. But an Agile build can do that too. But if things go south, then an Agile build has a massive advantage. Because you're much faster, you're much more maneuverable, and also you are much better at dodging torps. And it's this versatility that makes the Agile builds just so great, in my opinion. Now, normally I would just rush this Atlanta here and citadel him, but I know that there's a Richelieu waiting around the corner, so I won't be able to just rush out on my own. I will just get a totally pummeled by the three or four ships that are gathered here. And don't forget, there's a destroyer around here as well. And with my battleships coming up the left flank here behind me, I am kind of expecting him to be setting up an ambush here on the other side of one of these islands here. So I'm keeping that in mind. So I know this Atlanta has me spotted, so I'm going to goad him into action now, so I can hopefully take him out without showing any broadside to his other friends. And that was very, very quick taken out there, and with the agile build you can easily avoid his torps. It's not a problem. I'm not going to push forward. Again, like I said before, that Richelieu up there, he knows exactly where I am, and he's just waiting for me to pop my nose around the corner. And I'm going to wait until my battleships catch up before I turn this corner here. Now, my plan is for my battleships to help me soften that Richelieu a little bit. And I'm going to time my turning around this corner here. Probably sometime after the first salvos have been fired from my battleships. Because that means, obviously, they are spotted. And when they are spotted, I'm sure that destroyer, they're still around here somewhere. And if you notice, he's left the cap. So I am pretty certain that he is setting up an ambush here. So now is the perfect time. The battleships are just about to round the corner. And the Richelieu just fired. And he's busy with the battleships. So I'm going to turn this corner here and pretty much see what I'll find. I'm sure the destroyer is somewhere around here. But until I get him, I'm just going to focus on this Richelieu here. So the secondaries go off and we have the Mars right there. He is way too close for comfort for my battleships, but for me it's not a problem. I'm just gonna like approach him in such a way that he's having a really hard time torping me. Because this guy is trying to get away by reversing. He really should be rushing me because he won't last long. But all I have to do is just keep my bearing in such a way that he's really has a really hard time firing his torps. So I just need one more shot in, and he is out of the game. And I was pretty lucky here that the Richelieu didn't decide to fire on me, but like I said before, he was preoccupied with the two battleships that came around the corner with me, which is the whole point. Three ships coming around the corner is much better than just one, because you don't get there like solo picked on as I would have if I had come around about those 30 seconds before the battleships. And now the destroyer is gone, and this Richelieu just needs to be taken out. And as you see, I'm sitting behind an island again here starting fires, because you can do that in an agile build. There's nothing stopping you from doing that. So the Richelieu is gone, and we have Kutuzov left here behind the island. So I can see my battleship is taking the left side, so I'm obviously going to take the right side here, so we can get him from hopefully two sides. Now initially I was hoping to do this unspotted and just pop around the corner and totally surprise this guy and pretty much citadel him. But I do get outsmarted here, so I just continue. I am already committed, so obviously, I know this Kutuzov is going to fire torps my way. So I'm just going to make sure I get a citadel in. And then I am going to use the agile build to hopefully avoid his torps. And there they are, which is perfect. And just take him out. Bang. Done. So this means that we have now taken the left flank. And that means we can push to the right here and take good advantage of all the broadsides that are available over here. Because as soon as you win a flank, you automatically have access to broadsides. And again, I'm using an island for cover, because why not? There's no point putting yourself in danger unless you absolutely have to. So in this case, I could just go out in open water and shoot at this vanguard and dodge his shots, but why do that when you don't have to? There's no danger in here, and I'm safe, and someone else is spotting, so that's perfect. if this guy fell off detection, I would just go around the island, spot him myself, and then continue setting him on fire pretty much. But in this case, I don't have to. So that was just an example of what you can do with an agile build. One thing I want to just underline here, although this isn't a very challenging game. I mean, we pretty much steamrolled the enemy team. But what I want to underline here is that an agile build doesn't mean that you have to be agile all the time. Like, you use your agility when you have to, when you are evading torps, when you are kiting, or when you are like running from a superior force or something like that. Other than that, you play pretty much like an offensive cruiser, a more like traditional build. And the agility really only comes into play when you need it to. So that was a Charles Martel battle, and as you know, I absolutely love this ship. It's great. It's great. Very, very great. And I can only recommend everyone to get it, especially since it's free.